Hey guys, it's Athena from AmbiGaming. Welcome back to our Let's Play of Mass Effect. When we last left Commander Shepard, she heard a gunshot in the distance off where her Turian Spectre friend was. We were just about to go check that out, so guns drawn, let's go, guys.
What is that? Off in the distance.
Oh gosh.
It's a ship! Look at the size of it!
Freaking space lobster, space bug. Can I shoot it? Does anything happen? Oh no, it doesn't like bounce off or anything. Oh my god. Yeah, you better run. You better run for me, my little pea shooter pistol. That was all the geth came up? Let's see. Shepard, crouching and ready for action! One of these things. Whoa, what's that? Okay. Wah! Shoot him in the leg, Shepard, that's great. Okay. What is that? Oh, that's not anything. Okay, I thought it was flashing. Open this. I'll take your Omni Gel. Can we get in here? Ah! There was some. What am I not seeing? Okay, I'm assuming you guys got that. Nope, okay. Okay, fine. Didn't get it. Alright. Oh. Oh. Okay, here we go. Okay. Come on, work with me, gun. Woo! Okay. Let's try again. Okay. Sheesh. Alrighty. Alright. Now we can easily decrypt. Play a little more Simon Says. Simon Says, doo doo doo, Simon Says, doo doo doo. Cool.
Everybody stay calm out there! We're coming out, we're not armed!
Okay.
Is it safe? Are they gone?
It's safe, they are gone. It's safe, they're gone.
You're okay now. Nobody's gonna hurt you.
Those things were crawling all around the shed. They would have found us for sure. We owe you our lives.
I still can't believe it. When we saw that ship, I thought it was all over.
It showed up right before the attack. Knew it was trouble the second I saw it, so we made a break for the sheds.
Okay, let's squeeze these guys for information. Tell me more about this attack. Apparently there are geth everywhere now.
Tell me everything you remember about the attack.
The three of us were working the crops when that ship showed up. We just saw it and ran. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew.
They were by the garage, over near the spaceport, right where that ship came down. No way they survived.
You don't know that! We survived! If they made it to the garage, they could have had a fighting chance!
Well, here's hoping. Have you seen a beacon go by here?
Do you know anything about the Prothean beacon they dug up?
Oh,
we're just
that.
Farmers. We heard they found something out there, but it never really mattered to us. Not until now.
Now everybody wants it. Okay, I know you ran away from him, but can you tell me anything about the ship you saw?
What else can you tell me about the ship you saw?
I was too busy running to get a clear look at it. Mm-hmm. I think it landed over near the spaceport.
Tell them about the noise, Cole. That awful noise.
Mm. It was emitting some kind of signal as it descended. It sounded like the shriek of the damned. Only it was coming from inside your own head.
Was it possibly a jamming signal?
It was probably trying to block communications.
In your head.
Whatever it was, felt like it was tearing right through my skull. Almost made it impossible to think.
Okay. All right. Well, thanks for your time. Carry on, good citizens.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole, we're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
Well, they didn't technically lie to you. You know what? Yeah, tell me what's going on, buddy.
You have something to tell me, Cole?
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring. Nothing major. In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our sheds.
Crime does not pay. Well, no. Well, trying to think. She would go between one of these two. We're going to say that smuggling is a crime because I think she's going to try to, you know, maybe put some pressure on these guys.
You're breaking the law, Cole.
We're not hurting anybody. Hell, most of the time I don't even know what's in the packages. Just thought there might be something we could use. I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back. But you'll probably get more use out of it than we will.
Give it to me! Thanks. Now, if we had higher Paragon or Renegade option, you can, or Paragon or Renegade points, excuse me, you'd have the option to use, excuse me, one of these, dialogue choices, but we don't, so we're, and he gives you more stuff, basically. But we don't, so we're just gonna say thank you.
This should help. Let's move out.
I should go. Thanks. Okay, hey, cool, we got a stinger too. You know what, I'm gonna equip that really fast. Maybe? Oh, okay. Yes, I'm 100% going to equip this. I think, I'll faff around with everyone else's stuff a little later. Alright, so there might be survivors at the spaceport, so let's go look over here at the spaceport. Stay away from the containment cells, they explode. Oh,
Commander,
no.
It's Nihlus.
Oh, no.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Wait, don't shoot! I'm one of you, I'm human!
I appreciate that her gun now matches her armor. I'm sorry. Dude, you need to be careful. Like, have you seen all the guests running around here?
Sneaking up on us like that nearly got you killed.
I am sorry. I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Pal. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
What? What happened?
I need to know how Nihlus died.
The other one got here first. He was waiting when your friend showed up. He called him Saren. I think they knew each other. Mm. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him.
Oh no.
Shot him right in the back.
Mm.
I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
Well, we've been obsessing over the beacon, so let's continue to obsess over the beacon.
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform, probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend. I knew that beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I had been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
Apparently, cardboard boxes don't just work for Solid Snake. You can also hide in them in the Mass Effect universe to get away from the Geth.
How come you're the only one who survived? Why didn't anyone else try to hide behind the crates?
They never had a chance. I was already behind the crates when the attack started.
Wait a minute. You were hiding behind the crates before the attack?
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
You survived because you're lazy?
You know, sometimes I need a little nappy on the job too, but you can't just do that, sir. Do I have any other option? No. I feel like she wouldn't say that because that's just, I don't know, that just seems awful. So that's really disgusting, dude, that you hid. Yeah.
You ditch work, then you cower back here and do nothing while the Geth butcher everyone else.
Okay.
I don't even have a gun. What was I supposed to do, run out there and die? I couldn't save them. Nobody could. It was horrible.
Okay. I guess you were lucky then. Well, tell me about the attack.
Tell me about the Geth attack.
Yeah.
It was quick. 1 minute that ship was descending, the next, those Geth were swarming over the platform, thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
But you hid behind boxes, and that was okay. All right. So, we already talked about the beacon. He said, you know, it was probably off where Saren went. Do you have any interesting information about this ship?
Tell me about this mothership you saw.
I've never seen anything like it before. It was huge. Landed over near that platform. The whole place got dark as it came down. And it was making this noise, this sound that bored right into your brain.
Hmm.
That's what woke me up. The attack came a few minutes later.
So they're also alarm clocks. They're not just space bugs. Okay. Well, I'll leave you to your rest.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
Yeah. I'll take your little nappy. Alright, so before we go and find this other Turian, Saren, I think there's a thing over here. Uh-oh. We're not gonna be able to get things, are we? We can. Oh, that's good. Okay, so before we have to start shooting things... Yes, we'll take all these things. Okay, and now we will go be heroic. Okay. Come here, beastie. Kaden! Ugh. Enemies everywhere. Okay. Good heavens. Okay. Everyone heal. Yeah, come on. Okay, we're going. It's fine too. Am I dead? Oh no, Kaden's dead. Am I dead? Yeah, okay. I was just playing Dragon Age, where you body hop after the Inquisitor dies. Or Hawk dies. Or the Warden dies. That was such a shock. Did I miss somebody? Why is Kaden still dead? No, everyone's gone. Okay. Well, we're moving on without you, sir. Oh, these things. Well, Kaden will catch up. Yeah, when I first... Because I got into Mass Effect because I really liked Dragon Age, and it was kind of like, ooh, like, Bioware did something out in space, that's pretty cool. Oh, hold on. Oh, goodness. Oh, this is a problem. Also dying is also a problem. I'm gonna die. What? Okay. So, this was a real shock to me, coming off of Dragon Age, is what I was saying. You know, because I got used to, you know, in Dragon Age, if the playable character dies, you just kind of body hop to the next person in your party, so you really have, like, 3 or 4 chances to die. Before it goes to the game over screen. So I was playing this, and Shepard died, and it was like, would you like to continue? I'm like, Kaden and Ashley, you're still alive. Why am I not just playing as them? I have to say, it would be... we're back here. It would be slightly more convenient. But it's, you know... I mean, I obviously got used to it, but it's not really that super big of a deal. And I also understand. Did I get that? No, I didn't. Come on. by grabbing Medigo. Okay, you know what, everybody? Well, fine. Okay. I forgot what I was saying. Okay. Well, let's go. We all survived, so that's good. I can't wait till I get a little better armor and health. That would be great. Okay, let's see if I can get two shots off into this guy before he comes and annihilates me. Okay. Not sure if that... Are you trying to think? Okay, how about you guys go up there? There, thank you. Okie dokie.
Shields disabled!
Okay, just announce that to the enemy. Okay.
Shields disabled!
You can announce it too. Over there. And there, I always forget, I'm going to have to look this up, because there's one where you can, like, call them back to you.
Shield disabled.
Thank you. Alright, everybody heal. You know, you can tell them to take cover. And... I forget what they all are off the top of my head. I just remember, whoops, how to... Yeah, come on. I should have sent them forward. Let's keep an eye over here. Please don't die.
To me!
Nope. No, don't die. Ashley, take cover, please.
No!
Or no. No, that's fine too. At least for you. Okay, one more, right? Yeah. Did I shoot him in the kneecap and that counted? Okay, I'll take it. Alright, we don't have to crouch here. Medical kit, yes, please and thank you, because apparently I'm a much worse shot than I thought. Dum-ba-dum-ba-dum. Alright. Let's get to- ooh, train controls. Train controls, activate. Form of- oh, here we go. Yay!
Set the charges. Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
Oh boy. Is that the beacon? Here we come to save the day, now going the correct way. Okay. Saving data. That's good. Come on. Alright, here we come.
Demolition charges! The Geth must have planted them!
Okay.
Hurry! We need to find them all and shut them down!
Okay. I'm on it. You just keep them from shooting me. How about that? Run. Thank you. Let's do that. Okay. I really, really hope my people are doing something other than just taking damage, Kaden. Come on. Okie dokie. Nope. Alright. I thought I could be cheap and do that. Apparently not. Here we go. Oh! Well, that's a problem. Don't worry. Don't let me die. Jammed. Oh god. Okay. Oh, oops. I'm gonna heal. Heal. Do that. Do that heal thing. Thanks. Okay. And. What the? Oh. Okay. All right. That's okay. That's okay.
Demolition charges. The Geth must have planted them.
Hurry! We need to find them all and shut them down.
Okay, so we're back, and I realized that I forgot to disarm this one, so I guess it's a good thing that we didn't really make it through the last time, because that would have been super duper embarrassing as I ran around wondering where the final charge was. So let's try again. A little more accuracy this time.
Take cover.
I'm just gonna do this. How about that? And you guys don't die in the next 10 seconds. Okay. Cover, thank you. We're gonna do this. We are gonna contend with this insanity.
Shutting them down.
Yeah, shut them down. What do you have? Throw? No. What do I have? We're gonna have to. Ooh. Oh, I decided I don't like you. Okay, and throw. Yeah. Oh, come on. Oh man, okay. Did just clunk as I walked over there? That was pretty cool. Don't let me die! Ashley, where are you? Thank you.
On me!
Please, thank you. I'm assuming that is what's shooting at me? I hope.
Lost shield! Okay.
Alright. Ooh, what about that? Yay. So urgent, the music. Beep, beep, beep. Alright, disarming. And it should be good, right? Oop. Yeah.
I think we're good, Commander.
Thank you.
We thought this war was safe until the Geth showed up.
Okay. Where's Kaden? Yep, great. Yes, definitely take that. And there. Oh no, it's not there. Okay. Alright, let's keep moving. Scary music is still playing. What? Okay, let's.
All patched up.
This back pedal and shoot. What are you doing? Okay. Okay. Scary music has stopped. Perfect. Alright. I think there's stuff over here. I don't remember though. Nope, it was on the other side. Sorry, guys. Okay, we go at a slow trot. That's okay. Alright. Yes. While we're not going to be 100%ing, oh, we're Simon Says, yay! you know, I do try to pick up different things. I'm pretty certain we have all these things, but you can break down unwanted items into Omni-Gel, or you can also sell them for credits. But the Omni-Gel is good to have, because if you mess up decryption, or if it's too hard for your decryption skills, you can, if you have enough Omni-Gel, you can just kind of slap Omni-Gel onto it and open the lock, because that's secure. Like now, if I really wanted to, well, I don't have enough Omni-Gel, but if I wanted to, I could break down some of the weapons that I have into Omni-Gel right here on the spot, slap it onto the storage locker, and get whatever's inside. I don't think what's in there is all that important, so we're just gonna move on. Maybe, like, there's a Metagel pack or something. But we have more important things to investigate, like the Prothean beacon. Here we go. Found it. Huckle-Buckle-Beacon.
Normandy, the beacon is secure. Request immediate evac.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up.
Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Throws him.
Oh,
no. No, don't touch her. It's too dangerous.
Yikes. Well, we broke the beacon. And apparently ourselves as well.
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
That's a great dodge.
Must be eliminated.
I do like if you have the subtitles on for that section, when Saren starts freaking out, the subtitles literally say "Rarg, arg, rarg." Yeah, which is, you know, kind of fun. It's also interesting during the beacon scene that the companion that gets sucked in. Oh, sorry, forgot about this.
Doctor? Dr. Chakwas. I think she's waking up.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Great. Not great. I'm all right, I think.
Minor throbbing. Nothing serious. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Oof. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
Be more careful next time, sir. No, how could you possibly have known what was going to happen?
You had no way to know what would happen.
Oh, no.
Actually, we don't even know if that's what set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. Williams and I had to carry you back here to the ship.
Obviously, I was hurt. Because we're in the middle of space, Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
It was... It was a vision.
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death, destruction... Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our XO holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the commander's going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I just want to comment that, Caden is going to the mess hall, and Dr. Chakros apparently is just going to go evaporate. I do feel bad about Jenkins, because he was so excited. And it's not his fault that he was, designed probably after Leroy Jenkins, rah! Okay, so we feel bad about him.
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Well, thanks. Is Ashley Williams still here?
Did we leave Gunnery Chief Williams back on Eden Prime?
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Good. Good. That was a mistake. It's terrible. Good.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Lieutenant Elenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
Okay. Frickin' guess.
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
Okay, well, now that we've talked about my feelings, what did you want to talk about?
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain.
I won't lie to you, Shepard. Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
You also forgot that I'm now having prophetic visions about our death and destruction, but okay, yeah. We did everything right. Like, we just have to be honest with what happened, right? They'll understand.
I didn't do anything wrong, Captain. Hopefully the Council can see that.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren, that other Turian. Saren's a specter, one of the best. A living legend. But if he's working with the Gith, it means he's gone rogue.
Dun.
A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous. And he hates humans.
He hates humans? Well... I mean... I'm not sure how... And he hates humans... relates to he wanted the beacon. So I think she's just going to ask a follow-up question.
Why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how. I don't know why. I only know it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
I love how direct her why was. Let's see. I did see something. I think she's going to lay off the vision thing to her CO so she doesn't sound crazy.
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
Or, whatever.
A vision? A vision of what?
I don't know. Probably a warning of some sort.
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
Yeah, tell them that I'm having prophetic visions. I'm sure that'll go over real well.
What are we going to tell them? I had a bad dream?
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation, his politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
Well, if he's as bad as you say he is, he also shot Nihlus, so I think she's fully on board with this.
I'll find some way to take him down.
Yeah.
It's not that easy. He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
So I'll be a specter. Yes, sir.
We prove Saren's gone rogue and the Council will revoke his specter status.
I'll contact the Ambassador and see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Yes, sir. Okay, so we are actually going to leave it there, guys. I'm just looking at my timer. So join us next time. We will talk to our crew. And hopefully the frog will be out of my throat. We'll talk to our crew. We will go follow up with the Council about everything that went down at Eden Prime. So be sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our upcoming adventures. Until next time, thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you soon.